So you might be in the hunt for a to-do list application, or you're just nosy and want to know what the hot to-do apps of 2024 are. Today we're going to discuss some of those apps that are making waves this year and ones to keep an eye out for. Now, this video is sponsored by us. Welcome. If you're new, we are Keep Productive. We also have something called Tool Finder. So if you're interested, you can dig into any of the tools down over on Tool Finder, and all of the apps I mentioned, because I'm going to mention a fair few, will be linked below. So my name is Francesco, and I have been sadly interested in productivity tools for over 10 years. And one of the most interesting things to me are to-do list applications. And to-do list apps have evolved very much in the last couple of years with a focus on planning your day ahead. And the app I'm going to start with is AkiFlow. Now, for those who don't know, AkiFlow has been growing in popularity, and it's one of these applications that combines calendar and tasks in one. But what a lot of people like about it is very different, but very much like Sensama, it has something called task consolidation. And this is going to be a trend, I think, this year, even more so. And it's a concept of dashboardizing your to-do list. And what I mean by that is bringing all of your tasks into one dashboard view across multiple applications. And whilst AkiFlow has abilities to do list management, calendar management, whatever, it also has a way to bring in apps, tasks from apps like Todoist, Slack, Notion, ClickUp, and a couple of other ones. And that's really interesting because we're in the world of trying to make things a lot easier now, and that convenience of having one place to do things. A lot of people looking at Notion for that, but for those who are in Teams, and those who are more practical in the sense of they have a lot of different things happening around them and want to be able to consolidate, this is one of those apps for that. Sensama does something very similar in terms of consolidation and actually did it much more before AkiFlow in the space. But these sort of apps are definitely going to be hot in 2024 and beyond. In an age of AI, I think this is going to be a very interesting one. Brilliant segue into AI. The next app, it's called Structured. Now, you probably haven't heard me talk about Structured much. I did a review over on More Productive recently, but largely Structured has sort of gone under the radar with me. It's more of an aesthetic looking routine application, but I recently tested their AI assistant in it, and this is where it's heading in the future, I think. Practical to-do list AI, this is what is actually useful. So I check out a lot of to-do list applications and I see subtasks being generated with AI. That's not as useful as you think. It's just what AI thinks those tasks are going to be. They're not actually that practical. Whereas this function in Structured, it basically allows you to write or use your keyboard and just say, tomorrow I have a flight at 10 a.m., a meeting at 2 p.m., and I want to try and go on a run at 4 p.m. And you can just keep going. And basically it uses the, assuming the ChatGPT to the wrapper to basically spurt out your routine for you, but organized and structured in the app. Now that is very helpful because it saves and takes a weight out of planning your app. Now obviously this sort of segues to my third app, which is Motion, which does something similar but reorganizes your day ahead. So these sort of applications are super interesting because AI actually becomes much more useful in them versus being less useful and less practical. So that is two apps in one, Structured and Motion, both on my radar this year as AI applications that are doing to do list management right. Next up is Superlist. Now, Superlist launched after, I think, 4 years since they announced it, at least. I don't know whether this is true, but I just make an assumption that they weren't allowed to do or release it until their Microsoft relationship cut off. That's just total speculation, people. Don't come after me. I'm just assuming that's the thing that happened, the reason it took that long. But to be fair, development does take a while these days. But Superlist is on my list as one of the top or hot to-do list apps in this space because what they've done very well is released a very well put together to-do list application, but they've also got a bunch of AI features in there. And yes, some of the AI features are very like Todoist, like that ability to make subtasks, hate it, not useful. But they do have an ability when you bring in and consolidate Gmail, it summarizes that email for you, which is a good time-saving task thing in a to-do list application. So Superlist, I think, is going to be very expansive, and hopefully they'll introduce a calendar ability inside the application, which should make it much more accessible. I think some people, from what I'm aware of, are still getting some bugs, so at the same time, it's definitely ironing itself out from release, but I think it's got an interesting future ahead. And finally, number five on my list is Todoist. With their introduction of Team Spaces combined with their calendar, and I think that probably become mid-year assumption again. I think they're into actually trying to catch up in the to-do list space. I feel like AkiFlow, Motion, Sensama, these daily planners added calendar abilities and charged a much higher price, put a bit of a hot poker behind them and sort of got a bit of pressure going, which is great. That's how innovation is made in the to-do list app space. So I think Todoist is going to be a very interesting step forward in innovation in 2024. And I think largely as a whole, the to-do list space definitely needs that step forward in innovation. And I believe that in a sense, to-do-list applications will become probably one of the first steps in AI to actually start getting work done for you. So here's my hypothetical situation that in probably a window of maybe 3 years, your to-do-list app will do a bunch of different errands in the same way ChatGPT does for you and goes away and does a little thing, come bring stuff back for you, like a research task, or maybe communicate on email to a certain series of other AI agents and bots for you, and basically liaises and does those small things for you. And you utilize the to-do-list app much more like a decision maker. So you approve or you deny or you resuggest stuff to the AI that allows you to go and get more done in your day. So I think the to-do list application becomes a very different thing in the next couple of years. And I think the things that I mentioned in this video are that step towards that generation of to-do list apps. So very futuristic thoughts there, but ones that I firmly believe in. So hopefully you found this video useful. Do check out all the apps that are listed below that I mentioned, and I look forward to helping you find the perfect productivity app over with Toolfinder. Thank you very much, and I'll see you soon, folks. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Toolfinder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing. And naturally, there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.